Hallo! How is everyone doing? Here's the water. Ow. So how's it going, guys? I guess I should turn the camera around. You can actually see my face. All right. I am doing fantastic, I must say. It's been a little crazy coming back after being gone for basically 2 weeks and then being gone for 2 weeks and then all of a sudden coming back and then getting right back into work and hearting it up like crazy. I think that's my favorite part is all the hearts. So, yeah, and then just getting back in the work mode and just some ideas and things that we have been working on that are getting completed. Overall, feeling pretty good. I've been a little, I'd say I have a lot of high energy, but then I've also been a little low energy lately. So that's what's been, I'd say that's really what's going on with me. Where is everyone coming in from? Where are we? I'm in Maine. So we get the beautiful weather of Maine right now. And so where are you for the folks that are on here? Still getting familiar with this platform. So am I, so it works out great. What is your name? Dwayne Red Defining Rich One. I don't know who that is. But Red Defining Rich One. That is correct. Phoenix, used to live there, love it down there. Chicago, used to visit it a lot because I lived in Northwest Indiana. Susie, okay. And yeah, it's pretty simple. You just, if you want to host your own thing, you just press record. There's also a great woman, Brandy, that will teach you, she put together a guide about how to actually go about doing this. And what I could do is if you send me a message on Facebook, I can put the guide together. I can send you the link because she sent me the guide and I was able to go through it and it worked out really perfect. Brandy was in the group to try it out. But no, she told me to try it. Susie, you're saying that you were in the group that I said to try it out. And yes. But then Brandy was in our group, and then she put together a document that talked about how to go about doing that. Yes, the Facebook group. Yeah, I know. I remember you now. I just didn't know who your little tag was. But what do we have about business? Do we have business questions? Do we have want-to-know life questions? What has happened with Mike? But I have an interesting thing to talk about until you can kind of generate your question. The concept of, so I've been doing Watts TV. Many of you guys have been watching Watts TV for a while and have been doing every single video. I did a video every single day for 71 days and I'm putting it together. I'm actually resisting shooting my next episode of Watts TV. So I decided I would talk to you about it first before I started to actually film it, which I'm going to do a little bit later. Once I'm going to go paddleboarding out on the water out there and then come back and shoot Watts TV. And it's been a very interesting week since coming back because I was going to start shooting a video every single day as soon as I came back from being out over in California because we were off the grid for pretty much 7 days, so I didn't have internet, phone, or anything like that, which was really nice. But it also, I didn't shoot any Watts TV because it doesn't make any sense. There was nothing I could actually do. What's up, Brian Vestnors? And so I started coming back here and I started thinking about what I wanted to do with Watts TV and where I wanted to take it. But over the past couple of years, Kate and I have been working together on business really well, and I've been running all the operations and behind the scenes with our business. And there's been about 10 outstanding projects that have continually gone on for about 1 to 2 years. And one of the things I wanted to start working on getting those projects completed. And what I realized why I was editing Watts TV and when I was coming back before I started working on it was the fact of you're not able, when you're working on 5 or 6 or 7 different projects at one time, getting anything done is literally impossible. And it's funny, I just watched Casey Neistat's video, and for any of you that have watched Watts TV realize that I started a lot of Watts TV because of Casey Neistat. And I love all the hearts that are coming in. Like I said earlier, for those of you who just joined, that's my favorite part. And so what I realized during my putting together of Watts TV and everything that I was putting together with it, that I wasn't able to, I'm spending an hour and a half to 2 hours a day editing and then also promoting it and then also putting everything together regarding the video footage, shooting the video footage, remembering to shoot the video footage. All of that stuff was very time consuming, and it actually took away from production with our other projects and other business ideas that we had getting done. And I was getting frustrated around what was taking place because nothing was getting completed as fast as I wanted it to get done. And so it was actually slowing us down from moving forward in our business. And so 2 days ago, I figured out how that I was like, I have to step back from Watts TV to maybe one or two videos a week. Because I never said I was going to do a daily video forever. I did it for 71 days in a row, which is pretty awesome. And I compounded my learning experience. The one thing I did like about doing every single day was that I compounded my learning experience of what it would take for me to learn from, I would say, 3 to 6 to 7 months into 71 days. And it just was fast. And I figured out the direction I wanted to go a lot faster than many people who take 6 months to do something. So I think if it is something new that you want to try out, I like the fact of putting in a commitment every single day because you'll know very, very fast whether you like doing it or not. And I still like shooting a video. I'm going to shoot the video later today or tomorrow about explaining more about this. But the one thing that I realized during it was just like, where is my time and energy being focused? And I think somebody just wrote in about, you know, changing up your energy flow, changing up where it's going to go. And workflow, and it's exactly correct. It's very easy to say to do. It's very easy to talk about workflow and to put it that way, but to really understand that and notice that, sometimes it takes some time. And Kate and I have spent a lot of time over the past couple of years working on one project at a time and getting it nailed down. Where until that project's making income, until it's making money, don't work on anything else. And I would say that's where the biggest learning experience with Watts TV has come in over the last couple of days. And I've been really, hi Nancy Levin, how are you? And hi Deb. And so it was from the aspect of, I also felt bad about it though, which is weird. So this even brings more emotion into it. So what's the difference between this platform and a video and interaction is key? Yeah, totally. So, but it's also the when I thought bad about it. So I never made a commitment that I was going to shoot Watts TV every single day, but I also feel bad about not shooting Watts TV every single day. And I'm avoiding shooting the video that I need to say the video of shooting Watts TV every day. So it gets a little complicated and confusing, but it's all mind games we're playing with ourselves. But what I've also realized is over the past 2 days, because I've spent a lot of time in my office, which is right over here, and working, like there's been a ton of stuff that has been completed in the past 2 days, where if I was editing footage or shooting footage or interacting with footage, that it wouldn't have been done. And it's also a lesson in doing things for yourself versus looking at everyone else. Because as I was learning how to edit the videos and put the videos together, I was watching a lot of other YouTubers that were doing the same type of thing, like their same concept, like Casey Neistat, for instance, and a bunch of his buddies. And I really went after the high quality vloggers, the daily vloggers. And there's a lot of pressure around that. And also what the business they're building is much different than what I'm building. So it helps to focus and bring it back is, what is it that I'm trying to build in our business in my life versus what's their life about and how are they building their life? And is it the same? And it's not. So what Casey's building with the Beam, the app, is much different than what I'm building with, let's say, Feng Shui for Financial Freedom, two completely different things for our business, and putting together, like finishing up a project from that standpoint, or putting together MikeJWatts.com at the moment, stuff like that. So, yeah, that was a lot. So, what else was there? I think that was like a big thing about like what was going on with Watts TV today and any questions. So if anybody happened to be on here from our live event in California last week, how are things going? Like a week and a half ago, like let us know how things are going, or what is it in your business or your life that you use for project management? Is it something where it's focused on one thing? John Lee Dumas for Entrepreneur on Fire, when I was hanging out with him one time, he said what he's done in his business, which is incredible, because in 2 years, we just looking at his website today, I mean, the guy's making $250,000 a month, like in 2 years. How's the mama to be? I'll answer that. She is great. So in 2 years, like he's made almost, you know, $500,000 one month, $300,000 a month in a couple of years. And so it's been really cool just to watch his growth. And he said, focus on one course of action until success. And so that's like the biggest thing that I'm really focusing on and the direction we're taking our business. And Amber is somebody good to talk to about this. She does great Periscopes about focusing on one course of action until success, because she has built an incredible business in a very short period of time. And follow her right there. And then how's Kate? That was the question that just came in. Kate is doing really, really well. I'd say this last trip, she was really good, feeling really, really good. And then we went on a 12-day, 13-day adventure. And then the last trip coming back was really intense for her. And it's been a little bit of a longer recovery period than we thought just the past couple of days. But overall, and which it happens because it changed routine, it changed like sleeping at home, we were sleeping in random beds, like it was hot, you know, all sorts of crazy things. And it was like 106 degrees in Northern California at one point. It was super dry. We were at 4,000 feet elevation. So it was a little crazy. And Amber is great. We should just everyone post about how they love Amber. That should be the whole day today. And she missed the meeting on Monday because she slept for 5 hours in the afternoon, which was great. So she's doing pretty good. Like she is, I think we just hit 8 months, we hit 8 months being pregnant. Yeah, I hit 8 months of putting on weight during the pregnancy. That's good. But Kate is just hit 8 months making the baby, and the baby's doing good. It's really a lot of movement is happening. A lot of kicking is going down. Baby Megawatts is doing quite well. I will send her the love. I told her that we should do one of these together. How about that? She's resistant, but she'll come around. And what else? Overall, she's doing really good. And that's a cool thing. And I mean, I would say the biggest takeaway I could say during a pregnancy, because I've spent a lot of time researching and learning about birth, and as I've shot a couple of Watts TV videos about this, and I'll shoot more. But it's just the aspect that we're both going to be home, and it's going to be really a whole experience that I don't know what I can describe, because it's definitely going to be crazy, and we will do it together. And on the 14th is going to be awesome. So we'll see you guys on the 14th. For those of you that don't know what the heck we're talking about, anybody that signed up through B-School through us this year, 2015, we're having a live event called Make a Life, Not Just a Living event. And we really liked it in California. We had a great turnout of peeps. The people that were there were fantastic. A lot of value was into that. We've definitely learned some things that we're going to change for this event and put it on. And there's a pretty good chance that we'll move forward to do these events a little bit more in the future, because it was really, really cool and we're really looking forward to it. So that's something that's going to be awesome that we're looking forward to. And what else? Besides that, Kate's doing well. That was like what somebody asked, and she's doing well. I'm doing well. Thank you for asking. I know that was a big concern. Big concern of your life was how is Mike handling it. It's actually been a little hard, truthfully, and this is what I told Kate 2 days ago. It's been, nobody asked, but I'm just going to talk about it anyway, because this is me doing my own Periscope, talking to myself on my own camera. But there's people out there making hearts. But it is an interesting thing, because there is a lot of, I've talked to many of my guy friends that have had kids, and they feel for the first couple of months, and if not, it took my buddy a couple of years, honestly, and I think he's still going through it, trying to fix his marriage and relationship. And I know having children is one of the hardest things to bring into a marriage. And thank you. Now somebody wants to know how I am. I like that. But it is I'm feeling good about it. But it was. I told Kate 2 days ago. For a good 2 years, I mean. Let's see, we've been together now, February 2011, 4 years was February, so 4.5 years we've been together, really working business for the last 2 years together, and for the last 8 months, really since December, since she has become pregnant, there's been a lot of relaxation for her and just step back from everything that we've put into our business and work over the past couple of years, like since September of, really June of 2013, through our wedding and really through March up until this year. So about really of almost 2 years was go, 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 go. Since her book came out, it was like go, tons of interviews, lots of traveling, lots of adventures, and it was very little rest. And since, you know, once, and we were building all of this up for when we did have a family, we were able to take that time off to spend it with, so she could really be pregnant, you know, and really enjoy the process, be with the process. And then same when we set up with having our kid. And it, the whole time, like, why, one main reason I started my business was to be at home with our kids when we do have our kids. And we'll be able to make that dream come true, which is cool. But that is the aspect of me, you know, for myself, it was over the past, the wind is going crazy and people are just dropping everywhere. And, or acorns or something nuts from the trees. It was the aspect of, I lost my business partner for the last 8 months, really. I mean, she's still here, but it was like the interaction, the business meetings, what we were interacting with, how we were building our business, what the ideas, the concepts, the things we were creating, all of that stuff was, we just stopped. And because she needed to rest, she needed to sleep, she needed to take care of the baby and take care of herself, which is exactly what we wanted to do. But that shift was a little bit more intense than I thought. And I was happened to sit in our office on Monday. And that night I was like, I'm so lonely, you know, because I ended up having an office where I would go socialize down in Portland, and now I moved everything home. So it was just like a little thing where it's like, this is kind of lonely. But I don't know, I feel better about it today. It's like that one thing, you talk it out and it's good to go. But it is too, is like our friend just gave birth down in Massachusetts, and she was talking about how she never sees her husband, but her husband also has a job where he has to go to, and he was home for a couple of weeks, but then he had to go back. And I think things will be, it'll be an interesting experience why we're home. I know it's hard for dads, and I don't think, I know more guys are talking about it these days, and I've seen some podcasts around it, like being dads and all of that stuff, and I've read some books written by men on becoming a father and all that stuff, and I think I'm going to stop pretty soon. I'm reading two books called Brain Rules, Brain, B-R-A-I-N. One is just Brain Rules, and then it says something, and then one's Brain Rules for Babies. Phenomenal. They're some of the best. I would say it's around how our brain functions and how we learn, listen, that's, and how we learn around certain things. And they really do a good job of, especially around kids and babies and all of that aspect, and like educating the kids and babies around that. Does that make any sense? I think what I just said makes no freaking sense. It's like kids and babies educating around that. But just Brain Rules and Brain Rules for Baby. It was recommended by my buddy Simon, who said it's his two favorite books around parenting and just even the concept around the brain functions. And the hands down, it's not really about labor or birth, which is what's a lot of the books that I was reading, but now it's a phenomenal book. So I would definitely check those out. And I think it is true. I don't know, Eponce is like super excited, giving me lots of great insight, but I don't know your first name because I only see your last name. But it's, or your initials. But yeah, you've been, that's awesome. And I agree with you about, like, guys, I think it's something to be vulnerable, because being vulnerable is very scary. And it's, Eva. Okay, great, Eva. And I think being vulnerable is super scary. And it's something as a man, like, you want to be the protector. You don't want to let that fear in. And I think what happens a lot of times, which is what happened with me in my past relationships, which was different about Kate, is I didn't want to tell her how I really felt about things, because if you told somebody how you really felt about things, it was weak. And then, of course, the woman wants to be in a relationship where she feels protected or taken care of or protected, supported. And then I thought if I brought weakness into it or how I really felt about things, that would really, she would go away. She wouldn't feel safe, right, and taken care of. Which is true, and I know it happens in many relationships, but also Kate was very supportive with it when I would bring up something that's vulnerable, and she's like, great, let's move on. Great, let's see how we can fix that, you know, and as men, we like to fix things a lot quicker, and it's the same thing with her, where I brought up something, and she expressed that in a way. So, Yeah, so I think that's something that will come out, and I think I'm going to talk a little bit more about that, just becoming a dad, because it is hard, and I don't know if there is enough men. This is a very interesting thing around kids in general. It's like they want to keep a lot of things secret about how hard it is, and nobody wants to talk about it. That's what I'm learning from my friends with kids, and I could be completely wrong. But it is difficult, and I think it is something as from the guy perspective, like, let's bring that into a conversation. I think that's really more where I'm going to talk a little bit more about Watts TV leading up to that, because I haven't done, like, a Baby Megawatts video in a while. But I'll bring more of that into Watts TV. And so I like using Periscope a little bit more, and I'll probably use it more than I have before. So it would take place of like the every single day daily video that I was doing on Watts TV. Because I like the interaction. This is awesome. Vulnerable is good. Babies will help with that. Totally. I don't really know until it happens. But just from everyone telling about it. It's hard and it should be talked about. I like that. Well, that's awesome. Let's see. You guys said where you were from before, but I only caught Phoenix in Chicago, and somebody said something else. I think there was a Texas in there. Babies are awesome overall. There is true, and we came back from California, and so one of the conversations Kate, New Jersey, nice. And one of the conversations Kate and I was having about traveling with kids and all that stuff, Columbus, Ohio, Ohio State, Columbus, Muskoka, Canada. And Mackworth Island. Wait, Mackworth Island in Maine? Somebody live, do you live there? Or are you just out walking around? And Muskoka. Pronunciation is not my thing. But hopefully I pronounced that correctly. You live on Mackworth Island? I didn't know anybody actually lived on Mackworth Island. Oh, walking the dogs. Nice. That's awesome. So, what the hell was I talking about? Oh, yeah, we were talking about traveling. Oh, it's Heidi. Hi, Heidi. We were talking about traveling, and then we were on our plane, and we were in the, like, the lounge for American Airlines in the lounge, and there was babies everywhere. And I mean, we probably had 15 little babies on our flight, and I go, I think this just answers the question, can you travel with kids, or are we going to be traveling with children? So that, I believe, what time is it? What else? I'll stay on, I don't even know what time it is. It is 22 minutes. So we got 8 minutes left. I'm going to get off in 8 minutes because I'm going to go over here for those of you. I'm going to go out here, as you can see. Let's move the, I'm going to go paddleboarding because I need to go get some cardio in this afternoon. So that's what I'm going to go do. Go do some babies adjust to what you do. Correct. I mean, I agree 100%. We totally agree. Like, baby, we control the babies. Babies, I mean, babies control us too, but it's also the aspect of babies are just going to go wherever we go. Not having to take shoes off in security is awesome. I haven't done that in a while anyway, just because I fly TSA PreCheck. If you don't know TSA PreCheck, sign up for it. Google it. Sign up for it in your local area. Because it saves us a ton of time through security in airports, even if you travel once or twice a year. It's all about fast efficiencies. Kids under 12 don't have to take the shoes off, I guess. Well, that's awesome, too. But TSA PreCheck, do it. And I could give some definite, we could do a whole nother Periscope about saving time traveling airports. How's Kate's mom? Is she, must be super excited for a baby. My mom, I would say, is super excited. I think Chris is adjusting to being a grandmother. I think that's a good way to put it. She's excited, but my mom is like, when you think of grandma in the dictionary, that's my mother. Like, grandmother, pure grandmother. Chris is coming around. She is going to be an outstanding grandmother, and I think also for her, it's like when things are, one thing I've learned with Chris, it's like once things are present, like in front of you, then the real attitude, they're mowing our grass right now, our landlord, so it's a little loud. But it's like the reality of what's taking place is happening right in front of us. But I think it'll be, things will come around once the baby's there. But she's excited about being a grandma, and she's going to be awesome. But no, I would say she's excited. Is a good way to put it. My mom is super duper excited. My mom, this is what my mom. So, my sister hasn't announced this online yet, but I'm just gonna be. I don't think she'll actually watch this. My sister's also due 10 days after Kate's due. So my mom's getting two grandkids at the exact same time. And I'm gonna go inside for a second because it is loud. And so my mom's getting two grandkids at the exact same time, and my mom decided that she is going to take off of work. First she bought a new car. So my mom bought a new car that will be big enough because she had a convertible, and she bought a new car that's going to be big enough to actually handle grandkids. So that's crazy already, and there is no grandkids at this moment yet that are physically in human form outside of the womb. And then she's also going down from 3 days of work to 2 days of work to take care of my sister's kid in Indiana. So my sister's getting a sweet babysitting hookup. And well, I'm super excited. And she keeps sending us all of these little funky things. Like, check this out, I'll show you. She sent us this book from when I was a kid. Get some light up in here. This is the baby's crib. I'm starting the baby early because I'm giving the baby tools. So the baby Megawatts will be laying here and then have tools to fix stuff. So we're gonna start the baby off early. So the crib, but then my mom gave us this book called, or sent me this book called The Big Parade, which is a really cool thing, and we had a really good fun watching this. All right. And inside of it, she had this book made for me when I was two. And it says, "Mom and Dad, for this book, especially for Michael Watts, is 2 years old." And then it talks about my sister and my cousins and all that stuff. And it was put together. I don't know if this company still exists, but this is really cool. And so it talks about the story of it's actually kind of relevant to my life. What's the company, the book company called? It's called Create a Book. And they're in Kansas. At least this one was. I don't know if the company's still around, but Create a Book. It's a good thing for, I like it for kids. Because then she just sent it to me and she said she found it as she was going through stuff. And it was pretty cool to read through it and then we can read it for our kids. Amber, you asked me, do I know what do I think what the gender is? I don't know what the gender is. Sometimes I think it's a guy or a guy. I told Kate the other day, we're either going to have a guy or a girl, or a boy or a girl. Isn't it interesting that the older, it's like calling a baby a guy or a girl is weird, but really I'm still a guy or a girl now, and I'm also a boy or a girl, right? I don't know. So I thought maybe a boy sometimes, and then I thought it was a girl sometimes. So I go back and forth, and then I think about which one would be cool to have each one. And then Kate had a dream actually about our friend's baby, or Kate had a dream about a girl. And Kate had a dream, two dreams about a girl, and that happened to be our friend. The dreams were actually about our friend's baby in Massachusetts, and everybody thinks it's going to be a boy. So on the record, got it. From Amber, hashtag on the record. You should start a poll, like get the baby poll going. From our event in San Francisco, we actually have one, so that's pretty cool. Everybody did, or our event out in California, they put their send myself hearts, so I was double clicking. But I don't know. I think it'd be cool either way. Like I think having a little girl is pretty awesome. It's super special and super cool. And then having a boy would also be super cool and super awesome. And I think it varies. When we hang out with other kids that are boys and they're going crazy or girls are going crazy, we're like, oh yeah, we'll take the other one. But I know the personality is going to be whatever decides to arrive us. Wherever we need our biggest lessons in life, that's what will show up, I guess, right?
All right, I think that's it. Let's see how much time we got. We have 1 minute. So, 1 minute until I go paddleboarding. What questions we got? As your baby is healthy, it's all that matters. Correct. Correct. I agree with that 100%. Thanks for chatting. You're welcome. Thanks for participating. And I'd also say, that's it. That's all I got for you. I don't really have anything else to say. Unless there's another question that comes in. And how do we connect with you off Periscope? Oh, Amber, that was genius. Way to slide that in there. MikeJWatts.com. You can sign up for my newsletter, which I'll send out eventually one of these days. I just talked to somebody about finishing my site. That's been, ongoing for 2 months. And then Instagram, MikeJWatts.com. Twitter, MikeJWatts. Or it's not Instagram, it's not MikeJWatts.com. It's Instagram, MikeJWatts. Twitter, same thing. Facebook, I believe it's the same thing. I do have a fan page. There's not a whole lot that's there, but if you just Google Mike Watts, you'll find me. Find paddleboarding. Or if you want to buy some of our products, just go to katenorthrup.com because we have books. There's Feng Shui for Financial Freedom, which we've just added some new content to, which will be more coming out about that in the future. So that's fengshuiforfinancialfreedom.com. Just go ahead and give that one a nice plug. And glad that I stopped by. I will do that. Everyone says, Kate, lots of fun. And I got Kate's money book. Money, money, man, money. Have you read it? Lori, Lori, Lori. Did you read the book? It's one thing to get it. It's another thing to actually read it. Did you read it, Lori? Did you? Did you read it? Laugh out loud. Thank you for purchasing, though. But I do want to know, did you read it? Not yet. I just got it. Okay, great. So read it. Read it slow. Have a notebook by you. And when you feel resistance around something, it's probably something you need to take action on. Because I know that happens for me. And just keep your notebook there. If you have a partner in your life, maybe ask them if they'll read it with you. Do it together. Do the exercises in the book. Amber says, read it, people, read it, read it, read it, read it, people, read it, read it, read it. We're actually doing something really cool. So I'll just tell you before we get off with the book that I just started, and I'm starting to put all this stuff together. We're actually redoing the book page on Kate Northrup's site right now. That should be live really, really soon. And then we have over 44 money love stories that come with the book that came up with it, that we interviewed experts, our friends, like people we know, people that have done cool stuff. Experts. What is an expert anyway? I don't think experts actually exist in the world. I just think it's people that have studied something for longer than me that are better at it than I am. Does that make them an expert? I don't know. Anyway, but we're redoing the book page right now. That is should be done within the next week. So I just have to go through. I'm finalizing all the copy. I got to finalize one or two graphics. Edit. Get the length correct. So the money love stories, what I realized over the time is that there's 44 of them, of these so-called experts or our friends, talking about their money love story and their money love journey. And it's really cool, like some really cool people that are on there. And I realized that all of them on one page was a little overwhelming for folks because they're like, oh my God, I got to watch 44 in one day. But the truth is you don't. So we're actually going to create a weekly series for it where you can sign up for the emails. And then you just get that dripped once a week. You're going to get a new story. And they can range from 5 minutes to up to 20 or 30 minutes. And some of them are phenomenal stories. And so I think it's just going to turn out a lot better. So, but what we're also doing with a lot of the past readers is then we're going to start getting some folks who have had a really cool experience with either with the book, like some stuff that's really happened. And if any of you, sorry, like sitting on my meditation stool, and then I also have a electrical outlet in my back. For those of you that maybe that are on here that have had a cool experience with the book, then we're going to get some video testimonials from folks and just feature them on the site. Because I think sometimes when you look at, let's say, someone that we interviewed we did an interview, let's say Daniel Laporte, for instance, right? So we did, I don't even know if we did an interview with her, I can't remember, but just for example, like somebody might look at Daniel Laporte or Kate for that matter, or me or whoever, probably not me, but for Kate, let's say, and be like, oh, they have everything together. Like, oh, they're so polished. They don't make any mistakes. They don't have any worries. They don't have any fears. And I know I did this too when I looked at Up to Mentors when I started into business and people that I was there. But the truth is we do. The truth is, we have a lot of them. Like I just talked about for the first 15 minutes of this call about shooting Watts TV every day and what that's led into, and then to leave all that. But we do have that, so it's cool to experience that. And then what we're doing with individual readers that have read the book that have been impacted, I'm asking for video testimonials. Literally, just sit in front of a camera like this and just shoot about their experience reading it and what's changed in their life. And I think it's going to be really impactful for other individuals. That is somebody like Lori, who's watching this right now, that hasn't read the book yet, but to have other folks who don't have these huge presence or these, you know, these followings online, or that are new into business, or just say they have their regular job and they just want to pay off a $500 credit card, something like that. You know, so it's bringing it down so you can feel that you can do this yourselves. And those will be able to be featured, because I just was watching the video of one of the testimonials that came in. It's like unbelievable what happened to this girl. Like, unbelievable the experiences and changes. And people have paid off thousands and thousands of dollars from reading the book on that Kate wrote, and just credit cards paid off, and just the stories they're epic. They're unbelievable. That what's happening just from reading this book. And so it brings it back into and yeah, let's add one more thing about the book, because I think that's really cool and important. It is one of those things where it's and let's talk about the world of creation real fast, because we're gonna keep going on this, because I think it's really important. Is I believe that we go through this world where we have to create, and it's just like, for instance, like Kate's book, and she wrote a blog post about it, or talked about it. She talked about our event in California, how Hay House wanted another book, but she just didn't want to start putting out books and books and books. She wanted to, put out something that she feel called to do. And it's like, she already wrote one book about money, and she's already said everything she needs to say, why all of a sudden hash out something else into another book and just sell it, another book, just to get another book sold? And she realized, like, she's like, we're going to, and I think with, excuse me, what we're doing with the book we have now, it's really putting amazing things into place for the future. So it's like redoing the book page and really focusing on what we already have out there to make it a little bit better. Because I know the content we have out there is really good, but it's like to make that structure a lot better for folks. And I think that's what we're going to do. That's where we're going. That's what we're happening. That's what's happening with the book page. That's what's happening with the book. That's what's future coming out with testimonials from people that have had an impact with the book. And that's what's going down. It's what's happening in the house of Watts and Kate, Mike and Kate. All right, cheers, guys. Thanks for participating. I really had a great time. I really enjoyed this. And till next time, we will see you on the flip side. And make sure that you're living the life and business that you truly want to live. Take care.